Reawake is events for spiritual people, fun events for spiritual people. That's what it is, really. I've been organizing some parties, some weekends away, retreats, you know, hikes, things like that. People that are on some kind of spiritual path, some kind of shamanic path, in many cases, some kind of plant medicine path, you know, people that are interested in deep diving and examining all the different parts of themselves and integrating it all together so that they can be a whole or complete person, you know, rather than being fragmented and having bits that you're ashamed of and bits you're trying to exaggerate and bits you're trying to hide and, you know, because if you think about it, and it's perfectly normal, most of us and most people in the world are fragmented, isn't it? You know, there's bits you don't want to think about, bits you don't want to look at, bits you don't want to see, bits you're ashamed of, bits you're embarrassed about, bits you're afraid of, bits you're hurt about, bits of life you're disappointed about. And then we kind of project all the other bits, you know, that we think the world wants to see. And some, you know, that kind of works on the most part, that's all right, you know, we can muddle through, can't we? We can muddle through like that. But, it causes a few problems, doesn't it? And the trouble is, the more stuff that's unconscious under the surface is swirling around under the surface, and everybody's unconscious stuff is bumping into each other, you know, and we upset each other, we get annoyed by each other, we hurt each other's feelings, we betrayed people, and many of it is for unconscious reasons, because all these unconscious motivations are dancing around under the surface. The shadows are dancing around under the surface. And so I suppose what spirituality is, really, is examining all that and slowly integrating it and becoming aware of it, you know, becoming aware of all these different parts, all the bad bits, all the good bits, and understanding them and saying, oh yeah, it's all okay, isn't it? It's all okay. Let's bring it all together. Let's be full and complete and let's be ourselves. And that's better then, isn't it? That's better. I don't know. It is, isn't it? It just feels better. And rather than feeling like there's parts of yourself that are broken and inappropriate, you can come to the realization that it's all fine. We're all whole and complete. And also, once you accept yourself fully like that, then you accept other people as well. So when other people are being a pain in the ass, you just got more compassion, more understanding, more tolerance for other people's nonsense as well. And so you see, and when other people don't feel judged, they actually feel safe to come into a better place themselves. You know, when other people don't feel judged, they don't have to be so defensive and all caught up, and they can relax and kind of, you know, emerge. So we all help each other emerge. We all help each other emerge, but it's got to start with ourselves, isn't it? You know, the more you work on yourself and you come to peace with yourself, the more you allow other people to feel safe to come. You know, it's a group effort, it's a team effort. So you can't just tell other people off and point the finger at everyone else. You've got to start with yourself. Yeah, that's it, isn't it? That's it. It's quite exciting in a way, and it's perfectly possible. It's perfectly doable. You know, this is within reach, you know. All you got to do is, it's like anything in life, you just got to make the conscious decision to focus on it. It's just like learning piano, you know, I am going to practice and I'm going to do this and I'm going to, you know, and once you start to believe it's possible, then your certainty and your confidence slowly starts to rise and you think, ah, yeah, I can do this. I can integrate myself and come to more peace with myself and come to more self-love with myself and have better relationships with other people and have a better, more flourishing, more fulfilled, more satisfying, more fruitful life. This is possible. I can do this. That's exciting, isn't it? That excites me. It's not necessarily a quick fix, but the thing is, if you're on this path, what should we call it? What should we call it? Emotional healing, spiritual healing? Let's call it spiritual healing. If you're on this spiritual healing path with other people that are also committed to it as well, the process is fun and enjoyable. The process of self-discovery and doing it with other people is enjoyable. So, the process itself becomes enjoyable, you know? So the process itself doesn't have to be a struggle and an unpleasant thing. You don't have to do it in isolation. You just have to get around other people that are committed to the same. And that's it. That's what spiritual healing is. That's what shamanic paths are. Sometimes there's plant medicine involved, sometimes there's not. There doesn't have to be. I think these days it's getting more and more acceptable to talk about it. It's getting more and more understood and more mainstream. You know, there's a lot of talk about magic mushrooms and various other natural teachers, natural, you know, they go by all kinds of different names. There's all kinds of different labels that people give to them. What should we call them? Let's call them plant teachers. Yeah, plant teachers. Psychedelics. It's getting more and more understood. So I started eating magic mushrooms quite regularly about a year ago. It was the summer of 2021. And I don't know what it does, but it was very beneficial for me. It seems to just make connections inside your mind. Just this sense of clarity, like things make sense. Things that had previously bothered me just didn't seem to bother me anymore. They just suddenly made sense. I suddenly had like a more high resolution understanding of other people's behavior and why other people had done things. It just made more sense. It just became clear that they had done that for their own reasons and it wasn't because of me, and you take things less personally and then you feel lighter and everything. I don't know, somehow everything feels better. Everything makes more sense. And it's not a high. It's not a temporary high. It's not just a serotonin dopamine dump that makes you feel good for a few hours and then it's over. It's not that. It's a connecting the dots process. It's an integration process. It's a permanent reconfiguring and rewiring it's like an electrician going through the house and ripping out all the crappy old wires that have burnt out and, you know, and putting all new stuff in and new sockets and better fuses and better trip switches and new smart home. Sorry, I'm really going off on the analogy here, aren't I? But it's like rewiring your thoughts and your feelings, you know, so that they're all clean. It's like giving the car a service. Yeah, you get the idea, right? It's yeah, that's what it's like. So, but that's plant medicine, you know, the commitment to emotional healing doesn't have to involve that. It doesn't. There's many paths. And you can embark on whatever path feels most comfortable to you. It's not a competition, you know, it's not a competition to see who can drink the most ayahuasca. That's not what it's about. And if you're around the right type of people, you won't get any sense that there's any pressure to do any of this. If you're around the right environments and the right people, you'll feel comfortable, you'll feel safe, you'll feel empowered, you'll feel lighter, and you'll feel you'll feel like you can, you'll know the next step, you'll know the correct next step to take. It'll become obvious to you. A sense of certainty about what to do next. An increased sense of certainty and clarity. There you go. How'd you like that? That's it, isn't it? Yeah, so I've been organizing social events really to bring these kinds of people together. That's what Real Awake is. Real Awake, yeah. It started off at a couple of parties at my house here at Pentra Plaza. Got a party coming up soon. And then it developed into sort of weekends away. I've done a few weekends away with people where there's a group of 20 of us, the first one, 25, the second one. We just spent all weekend, nothing too serious. We spent all weekend just having a nice time with people where you can have these kind of deep conversations without any pressure, without any pressure. It was wonderful, you know. We had music. We had food together, we went for walks together, we swam in the lake together, we danced together, we sit in the hot tub together, we sit around the fire together. Nothing too serious. And I think that's what's kind of unique about what I'm doing. It's kind of like spiritual retreats, but nothing too serious. None of this needs to be taken too seriously. You don't have to view any of this as some big, arduous mountain to climb. You don't. Be careful of getting sucked into that story, like you're fighting a big battle and you're the hero of some epic adventure tale and it's all a struggle and you're so downtrodden and it's all so difficult, isn't it? Be open to just lightening up a little bit. Be open to that. Be open to that. Because we can get addicted to all kinds of stories, can't we? We've all done it. You get addicted to your story of struggle, your story of how life's been unfair to you or whatever. You can get hooked into all these stories. And that's all right. That's all right. We're not going to tell you off for it. That's all right. Yeah, have a good story. Have a good story. There's nothing wrong with a good story, is there? But, you know, the thing is, just be aware. Just be aware, innit? Just be aware. It might just be a story. And there might just be an easier way. Path of least resistance. Path of least resistance. So, what's the goal? What's the goal? What are we trying to achieve? Well, it's quite simple. I think, personally, I can only speak for myself. I'm trying to enjoy my life before I die. Just trying to enjoy my life as much as possible before I die. I know life is serious. I know that there's lots of responsibilities and there's lots of difficulties and pressures. We all know that. But within that, we've got to find the dance, haven't we? We've got to find a balance of enjoying it, making fun out of it, dealing with it, handling it, doing it elegantly, gracefully, in some kind of way that flows, and we can be creatively self-expressed and, you know, express ourselves fully in the process. There's no getting away from it. Life is a struggle. You know, there is suffering in life. But embracing that and not trying to push it away and deny it, that's part of the dance. Embrace it. Yeah, we're going to feel bad, aren't we, sometimes? We're going to feel sad. We're going to feel frustrated. We're going to feel heartbroken. We're going to feel all those things. But on the spiritual path, accepting that and embracing that and understanding there's no getting away from that, that's just part of it. That's part of it. And once you accept it, the tension and the pressure, there's not so much pressure. When you're fighting it and pushing it away, I don't want to feel bad. I don't want to feel negative feelings. That's where all the struggle is. That's where all the suffering is. Fighting and resisting and denying and fighting and resisting and denying. When you accept that it's all part of the kaleidoscope, then there's more ease in that and you can dance. You can dance with your problems then. Dance with your problems. And this is the thing, isn't it? When you're around people that understand that, have got the same attitude, and you can speak openly about your difficulties, somehow, a problem shared is a problem. Is not so much of a problem, is it? So that's it. Get around some good people. That's it. Get around some good people. That's what we're doing. Real awake. Get involved. I look forward to meeting you all. I look forward to seeing you all, whether it's at a festival, whether it's at one of my events, one of my retreats, one of my parties, one of my hikes. It don't matter. If you've got something going on, let me know. I'll bring my gang with me and we'll do it all together. How about that? All right, everyone. Feel free to reach out. I'm on Facebook. Drop me an email. Drop me a message. I'm very accessible. So let's connect and let's create the world we want to create. How about that? All right. You take care. Bye.